When you study the Bible from Genesis, you will understand that God had existed before the heavens. Because Genesis chapter 1 verse 1 says, in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth. It means that God was somewhere. He was dwelling somewhere. There must have been an abode of God. Heaven was not there before God. It was God that created the heavens. And when you look at verse 2, he said, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face. Meaning that the Spirit of God. And when you look at verse 26, he says, God said, let us make man. This means that in verse 2, we are told about the Spirit of God. In verse 26, God was talking to other personalities. God was talking to other beings that he had created before the creation of man. He said, let us make man in our own image, after our own likeness. That means when he says, let us make man, he's talking to other beings, which I believe most of them are angels, because God was working. The Godhead, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit was also working in conjunction with other created beings that he had created before man. And these beings are angelic beings. Good morning. You are welcome to I Prevail with Joseph Adenuga. This morning again, God put a word in my mouth to speak to you, to motivate you, to encourage you, to inspire you, and to bless you. And I believe today, God himself is going to bless you mightily as you hear the sound of my voice in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, I pray this morning that God will fill you with divine understanding and wisdom. God will give you divine ability to overcome and to win. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. I'm still talking about the working of angels. If you can recollect, if you have been hearing me for 2 days now, I've been talking about angels. And I said to you yesterday that even though we cannot see angels as a result of the fact that angels are spirit, Hebrews chapter 1 verse 7 says, now, and of the angels, it says, you know, it talks about the angels as spirits. Angels are spirits. They are sent to minister to the saints. Angels of God are spiritual beings. And so because they are spiritual beings, we cannot see them. And the fact that we cannot see them, because that's the way God designed it to be, it does not mean that they do not exist. And I said yesterday, so many things that we cannot see controls our world. You see, the remote control that we use in our houses, when we press it, there is certain things that happens to our TV. When we press the remote control, our TV is controlled by that button. Because there's a vital connection between the remote control and the television. There are so many, you know, there are so many unmanned, you know, planes or airplanes that works in the sky that are not manned by human beings. Because there is a vital control between the remote and those things. Also, there are things that are existing in the atmosphere that we can never see them. But that does not mean that they are not working or they are not real. Unseen things and personalities are as real as the things that are seen. Having said that, I want to just remind you again that yesterday I talked about two types of angels, the angels of God and the angels of the devil. The angels of the devil are the fallen angels. They are also called evil spirits and demons. The reason why they are called evil spirits and demons is because they rebelled against God alongside with the devil in heaven. And so when you look at Revelation chapter 12 from verse 7, you will see where Archangel Michael fought against the dragon and overcame him. And the devil, the dragon, was thrown out of heaven with all the fallen angels. The Bible says that about one third of the angels of heaven followed the devil. These are the fallen angels. We call them the evil spirits and demons. These demons are in our world. We don't see them, but they are real. See, these demons are the ones, they are the personalities that the Bible calls in Ephesians chapter 6 from verse 12. He said, but we wrestle, he said, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of darkness of this world and the spiritual wickedness in the heavenly places. These are the demons that the Bible is talking about. These are the forces of darkness that are in charge of all the things, the bad things that is happening in our world. And when you believe and you know, according to the Bible, that the devil is the god of this world, Jesus Christ, our Lord, called him the prince of this world. And we know from scripture that the devil is ruling the world. If he's ruling the world, he's ruling the world with those demons. And those demons are the ones that are in charge of the sicknesses. They're in charge of the incurable diseases. They're in charge of poverty. They're in charge of unhappiness. They are in charge of chaos and all the bad things that are happening in our world. We don't see how they do these things because they are spirits. This is why we need to understand the study of spirits, the study of angels and demons. Angelology and demonology are things that you need to understand. That is why I bring them to you in this daily broadcast. But because of time, this is where I'm going to stop today. I hope to continue this tomorrow, God willing. Thank you for listening to this. And I thank you. And I want you to please rebroadcast this to somebody. It's going to bless somebody. Having said that, please, tomorrow is Sunday, and I want you to come to Prevailing Church, Springstown, Johannesburg, South Africa. My friend is coming, and I know he's going to bless you. He's a prophet of God. Hallelujah. And I know the Lord God Mighty, the Lord God Almighty is going to use him mightily to bless you. So be there by 10 o'clock. It is in the second street of Springstown, second street, almost opposite Stop Center Club. God is going to bless you as you come. Please rebroadcast this to your friends once again. And if somebody rebroadcasted this to you, you love this. This is what I do every day. I send it free. Just save my number, +27 74 03 02 381. Save it with I Prevail. Go to your WhatsApp and send me a message, and the message should just be add me, and I will add you from tomorrow. You begin to receive this directly from me. Thank you so much. Once again, Joseph Adenuga signing out this morning and saying to you, be blessed and remain blessed.